Melasma is one of the most stubborn and mysterious skin conditions out there, and is characterized by those dense brownish patches on the skin that appear symmetrical on the cheeks, forehead, upper lip, and chin. And you'll find that it's one of the most common conditions skin experts see their patients treating with all sorts of products. So in this video, I'm going to go over 5 mistakes you absolutely need to avoid to get the best results when treating dark spots in melasma. So stay tuned till the end. Hi guys, you see Narcelin Media Pharmacist here on YouTube. On this channel, I help you guys make better and more informed decisions about your health and wellness. So if that's something you're into and want to be part of, be sure to smash that like button below now. Also, while you're at it, hit that subscribe button too to join the Aspires family. So without further ado, let's get straight into it. Now, if you've been following me for a while now, you'll know I've already talked about melasma, the causes, the types, and the treatment products I recommend for treating melasma. So definitely check that video out by clicking the I button on the upper right hand corner right after you watch this one. This video is geared towards those who have already started a product and are wondering how they can get the most benefits from it by avoiding certain mistakes. I'm willing to guarantee that if you avoid these 5 mistakes, you will have better results and you will be that much closer to getting rid of those hyperpigmented patches. So if you haven't liked the video yet, give it a like down below and let's start with number 1. The first mistake is forgetting or avoiding daily sunscreen. Sunscreen is essential for anyone's daily life, but extremely crucial for those experiencing melasma. The truth is, the reactivity of the skin that is already prone to hyperpigmentation and melasma is exacerbated by UV-induced inflammation. So choosing an SPF with added melanogenesis inhibitors and antioxidants provide additional treatment and pigment suppression along with necessary UV protection. Just remember, all sunscreens must be applied 30 minutes before sun exposure and reapplied every 2 hours or after swimming or sweating for maximum protection. Research also shows us that exposure to UV rays and visible light can induce inflammatory response, which stimulates melanocytes through mediators such as reactive oxygen species, which makes pre-existing hyperpigmentation worse. So if you're forgetting sunscreen or think that it's unnecessary, you could be reversing the hard work you're putting into treatment. This is especially true in pregnant women in which sunscreen may be the only therapeutic option available. The second mistake is frequent exposure to heat, sun, and light emitting sources. As for the sun, we have already covered. Visible light emitting sources such as tablets, computers, or cell phones, and even heat itself can worsen or trigger melasma. And this can be as simple as opening a hot oven near your face, especially if heat is one of your strong triggers. You see, anything that causes heat or friction in the skin can stimulate an increased deposit of excess melanin at the site of trauma. This has been demonstrated in many studies when they assess the use of intense pulsed light, laser, microdermabrasion, and a high percentage of chemical peels to treat melasma. Heat is a very common trigger for melasma as it increases vasodilation. When we think of melasma, we think of hyperpigmentation. However, vascular dilation often occurs in the affected area as well. So when heat leads to more inflammation, in turn, it can then lead to stimulated melanocyte pigment production. So when you can, avoid overhead work lights, overhead desk lamps, extensive cooking over an oven or a grill, heating lamps in general, and yes, your hair dryers too, as they can get up to 140 degrees of heat, especially when heat is a known trigger for your skin type. Definitely stay tuned till the end, as there's one other everyday use item that may be causing melasma that I'll reveal at the end, so don't click out just yet. The third mistake is experimenting with homemade recipes. The problem is that homemade recipes is that they are homemade. They are not clinically formulated. They may aggravate and irritate the skin, stimulating inflammation in the region, which can worsen melasma and cause even more spots to appear. Because melasma is so common, there are a lot of flashy advertisements trying to sell you that miracle cream that just don't work. Bloggers and influencers may also convince you to try their DIY treatments that promise instant whitening and impressive before and after photos. These treatments do not work, and it's usually just a scam just to take your money. There, I said it. I've seen some DIY kits that are tailored towards exfoliation, but may prompt over exfoliation if the instructions aren't clear, which becomes a serious concern for the skin. I've even heard some recommend microneedling with online kits, but you guys already know what my take is on them. They can still trigger an inflammatory response, leading to a worsening of pigmentation if too much trauma is induced, and you don't know how much trauma actually gets induced, so it's best to have this professionally done under a dermatologist's care. The fourth mistake is believing that melasma can be cured. There are two reasons that melasma is so hard to cure, and people don't know why. But I'll get to it. The first reason is because even minor amounts of sun exposure can darken or reactivate it. And it's hard to avoid all sun exposure, especially in women in the age group most commonly affected, 25 to 40, who may have children who have outdoor activities. The second reason is that estrogen and progesterone hormones go along with being female. And women in that age group are faced with a decision to either be on birth control pills or be pregnant. Both these factors can be triggers. The only other viable option is to have melasma be under control, which is absolutely doable. It's frustrating, but it is doable with year-round daily skincare focused on prevention. Even if you have had treated professionally once with a chemical peel or a laser treatment, it is possible for the condition to relapse, which makes prevention so important. The fifth mistake, and arguably the biggest mistake, is not seeking professional help. Only a trained healthcare professional will be able to carry out a correct assessment and examination of your condition. Because there's not a one-size-fits-all product or treatment regimen for melasma, there are different types of melasma, such as superficial, deep, and mixed. So to have it properly assessed, seek out the right care to have a tailored treatment that is ideal just for you. Oftentimes, the prescription treatment Triluma is prescribed, an all-in-one triple therapy which is very effective for treating melasma. It contains fluocinolone, a corticosteroid that lowers irritation and inflammation, hydroquinone, which is a melanin synthesis inhibitor which helps lighten the color of skin, and tretinoin, which is a retinoic acid derivative related to vitamin A that promotes new skin growth. Now, since you made it this far until the end of the video, I promise to tell you that one sneaky item that you probably use day to day without knowing could be a possible trigger of melasma and hyperpigmentation, and that is,
it's time for the moment you've been waiting for,
your aviator sunglasses, or sunglasses with metal rims or metal attached to the inside handle or rim. Because guess what? They absorb the heat when in the sun or when left in the car. As the metal gets warm and the heat transfers to the skin when the sunglasses are placed on the face, they can contribute to melasma as well. Let me know if that was new news to you or you've already known that. Also, let me know if any of these tips helped you. Be patient with this because there is a light at the end of the tunnel and I know that you will find it. I hope that this video helps give you a better understanding on melasma. Like the video if you did enjoy it and subscribe not to miss out on all other future videos. Thanks for sticking tuned all the way till the end, and I'll see you on the next one.